हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल। एज पर द सेशन ऑफ लाइट एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन, टुडे वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ए लेक्चर ऑफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ ऑप्टिक्स इन अल्फाबेट्स, दैट इज ए टू ई, इन ए डिटेल्ड डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड डिटेल्ड एप्लीकेशंस इन द एरिया ऑफ ऑप्टिकल सब्जेक्ट। This platform is showing in the theme of science and outreach program, a window to new world. Under this science and outreach programs, Jigyasa, SPY, OSA, SVC student chapters are involved. Myself, Dr. Praveen Kumar, completed PhD in Optical Coatings, CSIR, CSIRO, Chandigarh. History of Optics in Alphabets session showing A to E. So the first alphabet is A. A means astrology, astronomy. So under this astronomy, there are several kinds of things we have to understand. So astronomy means we will understand the space, spacecrafts, telescopes, binoculars and satellites. So what is astronomy? Astronomy is a oldest science and study of celestial objects, celestial bodies like sun, planets like Mars, Venus, Pluto, Neptune, Earth, Sun, Moon and stars. Under this astronomy, scientists can observe in which way the stars are there, in which orientation the planets are moving, what is the distance between these signs of planets, and how the life is changing in one planet to one planet can be observed, can be discovered by the astronomical scientists. With which equipments astronomical scientists will see? One is astronomical telescope and the another one is astronomical satellite. What is astronomical telescope? Astronomical telescope is an optical instrument designed to make distant objects appear nearer. It means the astronomical telescope is a small instrument. From this, if we are seeing any object which is far away from our naked eye, that can be seen very nearly in the form of small particles, small objects. From this telescope, we can see the far away objects to our eye in a nearer view. So what it contains, like arrangement of lenses, mirrors, all this will be focused and understand the phenomena of the light rays focus and magnified, and it forms a image, and that can be seen by our naked eye. So by the definition, astronomical telescope is an instrument designed to make distant objects appear nearer, containing an arrangement of lenses, curved mirrors that all are focused to form an image. So similarly, astronomical satellite, it is also a one kind of telescope which it have bigger than the normal telescope. So this telescope will be also called as telescope floating in space. So because these astronomical satellites will float in the vacuum or in the space, where it can collect the vision of gases, Earth's atmospheres, and all this contained information will be collected from this big telescope, and it makes an image that can be transferred to the stations of Earth or wherever it requires. So the definition of astronomical satellite is, it's a big telescope floating in space. Because why? It is not in orbit of Earth and it does not conclude the gases and make up the Earth's atmosphere, and imaging equipment is not focused by the heat of Earth. So this satellite telescopes are very bigger and it will be float on the surface of space to collect the information of gases, what kind of changes happening on the Earth's atmosphere can be focused and imaged. In this also, lenses will be there and mirrors will be there to magnify and to focus. So both are similar. Astronomical telescope is a small kind of telescope, will be utilized in laboratories and normal few labs of astronomy. And satellites will be a bigger telescope that can be seen in topmost surface of the space. It is also called as floating one. So we can say this is the difference between astronomical telescope and astronomical satellite. So coming to part of B letter, B means biology, biophotonics, beam combiners, all these three things comes under B letter. Biophotonics. Biophotonics means study of biology as well as photonics. Photonics means light. Bio means biology. Biology plus photonics, both are interlinked and it forms biophotonics. So this biophotonics is a group where it can be developed and applicable for the optical techniques, particularly in imaging of biological molecules, cells, tissues, as well as human bodies, all these kind of things will be formed. These techniques preservably integrated in biological cells and being examined. This biophotonics is a subject where it can deals with biology as well as photonics, both are combined and it forms a group of different subject to do a research in biological molecules, biological cells, biological tissues. So if you see this image here, it is in a human bone in the resolution of 460 micrometer into 612 micrometer. 1 micrometer is 1000 nanometers. So see how much resoluted images we can understand, and we can see what is the difference and where the bone fracture is happened, where the bone is in a good condition or not. We can see all this kind of information in the subject of biophotonics. Next, if you see here remaining some kind of images to understand the biological phenomena of plants. If you see, this one is a peacock feather. So if you see here, it's a colored image, and this is the imaging of biological equipment to understand how the color difference variations, how the grayscale and black and gray phenomena of images, how in which way the differentiation can be taken, can understand from this kind of informations. So the number three letter is C. C means color. So origin of color. Isaac Newton in 1666 experimented with colors and origin of colors. He concluded color is not in the glass, it is in the light. What Isaac Newton said, color is not in the glass, it is in the light. White light is a mixture of all the colors in the spectrum. So in the white light, already we have seen one experiment, mixing of colors. In that mixing of colors, if you see the diffraction grating, in the diffraction grating, we will see white light is dispersed into seven different colors. That's why white light is a mixture of colors in the spectrum. In the 19th century, the same another physicist, Maxwell, discovered mixing just three light sources to form red, green, blue in the similar manner, RGB, that is what we will say. These are the three different primary colors, which are red, green, blue. So Isaac Newton said that origin of colors experimented in 1666. He also said color is not in the glass, it is in the light. Also he said white color is having different kinds of colors. So similarly, computer monitors are LCD lights, LCD TVs, LED TVs, all these computer desktops laptops, phones, all these equipments will have three different light sources. By that we can form another kinds of lights, another kind of colors, that are red, green, blue. So under this origin of color, we can see one more time the experiment mixing of colors. Green, blue, red, after these three mixing, we will get yellow, magenta, cyan and white. So this is the thing which we can understand by this mixing of color experiments. Already we have experimented it, and if you want, you can see in my channel in the by the name of mixing of colors how I have demonstrated, how I have experimented the light of white, which it can be dispersed into seven different colors. So it requires light box, blankets, paper, aluminum foil, white and black construction papers. So the letter D. D means diffraction, D means diamond. So these two things we can understand from this D letter. The diamond is the hardest material, hardest compound in the universe. Why the diamond is hardest? What are its properties? Why all people are requires this diamond for their beautiful ornaments? So it has a very good properties. So diamond is an allotropy of carbon, in which all the compounds, all the crystals are oriented in a form of hexa octahedral structures. So this diamond is also a specified type of cubic lattice structures. Similarly, hexa octahedral structures, cubic lattice structures will be there. So what are its properties? It is having hardest material, thermal conductivity will be more, index of refraction and specific gravity and dispersion phenomena also there. Chemical composition of diamond is C. Like this, all will be utilized and it makes diamond to become strong. So one more property of diamond is it is having tetrahedral joining of lattice parameters, lattice structures to form this kind of hexa octahedral crystals. So these are the important properties of diamond, how and in which this diamond will be utilized in research and development purpose can be seen in this small video. So here in this we can see this entire instrument is known as single point diamond turning instrument. This single point diamond turning instrument is used to develop or prepare components like lenses, mirrors, for which kind of application? For space, for fighter planes, for R&D mirrors, for infrared optical instruments like guns, infrared satellite systems, spacecraft mirrors like gold mirror, platinum mirror, silver mirror, copper mirror, gold mirror, all these kinds of mirrors can be formed. So the next So it requires tape and cardboard structure and this kind of peep hole system. We can see how this diffraction system will be used to form in a very good way. See, there is a very good beautiful patterns are observing using this peep hole phenomena. So the questions which I asked you can be experimentally understood by this video also. It is E. E means eye. Eye is a main important optical component which is of having so many other kinds of materials inside the eye, like corona, pupil, iris, retina, choroid, sclera, vitreous lunar, hyaluronic canal. All these components will be used to form a very good optical system. These all things are will be one refractive index of variation in lens portions. After this only we can see if we can see the images of others from the eyes. Eye detects and sends light signal into brain by the optical nerve, forms image on the retina. What eye does? Detects, sends light signal to brain and optical nerve for image and retina. So after this one, it can be explained in an optical system of optical viewpoint. Here there are different kinds of arrangement of refractive index phenomena in this image. Human eye for optical engineer's view, we can see in such a manner. Eye is an adaptive optical system comprising of corona and a lens. So it is a corona and lens systems. Will be there. These optical systems of crystalline lens of eye changes into shape, focus of light from objects over a great range of distance on the retinas. So this is the very important, very fundamental thing which every optical person should be understand. Thanking you friends, thanks a lot. Myself Praveen Kumar, please subscribe to the channel for understanding more detailed sessions on history of optics. Thanking you, thanking you, thanking you.